I'm Daniela Rus, and I'm here with my PhD student Johnson Wang and my postdoc Byung-Chul Kim. And together, we are building towards the future of robot design and manufacturing. Specifically, we're building a system called DiffuseBot. The system combines the best of generative AI with the best of physics-based simulation to create a generative AI approach for mechanisms that can operate in the physical world.
This is an example of a robot that's generated by DiffuseBot, and its goal is to try to move that box. So it generates motion like this, crawling motion to try to move the box. It kind of combines the generative part with physical utility. First, try to build a physical simulation that try to provide kind of like a learning signal for the generative models to do the task in the simulation. And afterwards, we can actually fabricate it using 3D carbon printer. So think about now you want to customize a robot for a certain physical task. How long will it spend you to actually make the robot?
Maybe it requires 2 weeks to 1 month, maybe.
It took roughly probably 30 seconds to specify the high level specification. And then it took roughly like 6 to 12 hours of computer time to actually optimize the robot. And then I hand the design to Byung-Chul.
It requires 4 hours of 3D printing. And after that, I need about 30 minutes to 1 hour to post-process the printer.
So the entire pipeline only takes like 1 hour of human time, and rest of the hours, we kind of outsource that to computer. And this is the coolest thing of DiffuseBot. Like the previous robot where it tried to move the box from left to right, this robot, we specify the high-level objective as a picking up object. The gripper that's automatically generated by DiffuseBot using diffusion generative AI, it can learn to know to generate this kind of parallel gripper-like shape, and that can allow it to actually achieve the physical utility, which is clamp the object and then pick it up. We use the exact same pipeline. The only difference is basically we specify different high-level objective. So basically we still have this kind of physical simulation in the computer, and then it will automatically optimize the robot to this specific shape. The diffusion process actually looks like this. For example, it starts from kind of like a random noise, and then it gradually converges to a gripper-like shape, as we see in here and also in the physical robots. The most limitations happens in sim-to-real gap. Because of the material we are using, the stiffness is pretty large, so it requires a large force to actually bend the gripper and then generate desired motion to pick up the objects.
We have to think about the stiffness of the robot, so I have to redesign the robot's body to make it softer.
There's still some kind of gap between the actual material we use in the physical world and the simulation we build. So this kind of gap is kind of troublesome, and we are now working to improve this kind of gap so that we can actually generate the robots that can at least 95% replicate the functionality that can be achieved in the simulator. Now we are seeing here is a robot that a DiffuseBot designed to do locomotion. DiffuseBot automatically find this kind of four-legged creatures that can try to walk forward. It's kind of try to bend its leg and then try to use the frictions against the ground, try to push forward its body. When we are making the robot, there's some imperfectness during the fabrication, such that there is some kind of asymmetry between the two different robot bodies, which makes it try to move forward, but also rotating at the same time. And we found that the damping issue of the material makes the robot cannot achieve dynamic motion. It is moving forward in the simulation.
When we change the motor to the high torque density motor, and if we think about the pushing force, because this actuation is done by tendon-driven mechanism, which can only generate the pulling force. So maybe we can change the locomotion after that one.
The major issue that we are solving now in our ongoing project is try to make sure the sim-to-real gap is small enough such that whatever we can achieve in the simulation can be replicated in the real world.